Click the screen to subscribe.
Okay guys, it's been a little while since I've done a Blender video, but here I am back, and today we're gonna have some fun learning how to make a tree in Blender. Now when I first decided I wanted to make a tree, I thought you were gonna have to model it the same way you'd model a house or grass or blah blah blah, or somebody's hair, something like that. But actually Blender has a built-in tool that makes it easier to create trees, so you don't have to model them like you would everything else. And I'm going to show you how to do that today. Now, I do have Blender 2.77, but with your version, you should still have what it takes to do a tree. So I'm going to click right here. The first thing you're going to do is you're going to go to File, User Preferences, and we're going to set it so that you can add a tree. We're going to click Add-ons, and be sure to stay tuned, and I'm going to tell you a joke around the end of the video. Alright, so I'm going to click right here, and I'm going to search sap. We're not going to be adding sap, but we're going to be adding a sapling. Click that checkbox right there. Close this. X. Delete this cube. Alright, and shift. Well, I'm just going to click add so you can better see what I'm doing. And you're going to add curve. Add tree. Right click on the tree. Now once you add it, there's several things you can do to edit it and do whatever. Now don't move it or anything though, because once you really edit or whatever, for example, if I grab it, you notice I can't really do anything with it anymore. So you've got to set all the settings before you move it or anything. So I'm going to right click on it. Now there's several different things you can do here to decide what your tree is going to be like. The first thing we're going to do is click on bevel, and you see it automatically adds thickness. And this random seed here is really useful. What it does is it changes what your tree is going to look like. It just comes up with random shapes for the tree, whatever. I'm just going to type in 199, and I don't like that. I don't like that. All these trees are leaning. I don't want a leaning tree. Whatever, that one. I was about to rotate it, but not a good idea. All right, so now what you can do, here's an armature if you want to add an armature to your tree so that you can like make it sway in the wind or whatever. But I'm not going to do that, so I'm just going to go to leaves. And you can add, I'm just going to go here, put rectangular. The leaves are going to be rectangular. I'm going to check show leaves. So it's got the leaves right here. And that's good. Pruning, no. Branch growth. And I'm not really going to mess with that. Branch splitting. I'm going to add more than two levels because, you know, they're only around the top of the tree. So I'm going to move it to three. And, you know, this is a lot more leaves now. Base splits. You can do that and you see what it does right there. And you can increase the size of the base to make it a bigger base. I'm going to do 0.9. That looks good. But it doesn't look real. All right, let's just go back to 0.4. Alright, and that's actually about it as far as modeling the tree. That's basically all you have to do. There's different settings you can mess with. I'm not going to do a whole lot right now, but I'm going to show you now. First of all, sorry, numberpad 0 wasn't even telling you what I was doing. Numberpad 0 to go to camera mode and open up this one right here. Go here under view and check lock camera to view. Press numberpad 0, press M. And now if I press hold on shift and scroll up, I can move the camera, scroll out to zoom out, shift, scroll up, middle mouse button, drag, clicking it down, moving it, and I'm going to render. Alright, lighting's kind of bad, so I'm just going to edit the lighting a little bit. Man, I'm so tired. I was working, doing about like 100 pictures trying to do a Lego movie, but they're pretty cool. So stay tuned, because I might put one up soon, a Lego video. Anyway, back to this. What I'm going to do, right-click on the leaves, and we're going to put a leaf texture in them. Alright, there should be an annotation popping up on the screen right now. If you click that, it'll bring you to a link where you can download the leaf texture I'm going to be using. So if you download that, materials, once you're done downloading it, go to materials right here, new, I'm going to name it leaf. What did the tree say to the wind? This is on a Laffy Taffy wrapper. Leave me alone. Oh, that one's so corny. Alright, anyway, we're gonna go to textures, new, name it Leaf. You're going to go here to Image, click Open, Downloads, where the texture I had is. All right, it's called Green Leaf. Open the image. I'm going to click up here. There's a little three streaks. I'm going to hold down, drag to the side. And let me see here. My little screen recorder thing is in the way. Sorry. Dude, this is really annoying. Something's wrong with this screen recorder. So what I'm going to have to do... Sorry. I'm going to drag down on that one. Screen recorder's in the way. I don't know if you see it or not. Dude, I'm getting all confused. UV image editor. Sorry. Anyway, what I'm going to do... Press tab. And I'm going to X what was there. Sorry, I'm getting all confused. I'm going to click here. Click the green leaf. All right. Zoom out. Computer's being jumpy. Why do people say that? Because computers cannot jump. And it's glitching. So I think it's about time I tell you another joke. It's just being very, very... All right. Sorry. You're going to click right here. Go to texture. And we have a leaf. All right, sorry. I'm just dragging that down, putting this 3D view, texture. I'm dragging one down there so I can keep it on this side better, see what I'm doing. All right, scroll there, click X. Sorry if I'm confusing you with my Imperial Blender skills. I'm just kidding. I don't know anything about Blender. Anyway, I'm going to go numpad 0 to go to camera mode and render. And you notice that it's all white instead of green. The reason is because we're using a texture that has a transparent background, but Blender's not rendering it as transparent. It's rendering the background as white. So to fix that, you're going to go right here to textures, and you're just going to scroll down to influence, click alpha, and just put it as 0. Now if I render, you notice it's green now like it's supposed to, and put to negative 1. It looks basically the same, but that's pretty good right there. It looks like a tree now. All right, so now what I'm going to do, right-click on the trunk, and now we're going to add the bark texture. Another annotation should be popping up right now, showing you how to get the bark texture. We can get a link and download it. So new material, bark. Trees like to bark. All right, new texture, bark. If you're watching this video, bark. Alright, image, open, downloads, the text you downloaded, and I don't remember what its name, wood, okay, open image, alright, and there is no way to really, you actually can't assign this in the UV image editor, I don't think, so it automatically assigns it, so if you render it, we have bark now, so it actually looks like a tree. I'm just gonna... Now we can move this. Well, I guess we've already been moving. I'm just going to grab it. Move it right there. Scale it up. Render that. Move the lighting. And while I'm doing all this stuff, you don't have to do any of this stuff now, but you basically got the tree done. Congratulations. While I'm doing this, I'm going to tell you a joke. I'm just setting this up for some pictures. All right, so this is a little kid climbing a tree. Now, this wasn't a smart kid, because this kid tried to climb a tree as high as he could. That's not a smart thing to do. And, you know, I like climbing trees, and I try to climb as high as I can, but some people aren't made to do that. Anyway, this kid is just climbing the tree, and all of a sudden, he slips, and he falls, and he's like, "Oh no, God, help me!" And then he says, "Oh, wait, never mind, God, the tree caught me. My pants got caught on the tree." And yeah, so in case you can't tell, I need new tree jokes. So if you can think of any, please tell me, because I need them. But I think that's it. So I'm going to say thank you for watching this video. That's why I got here. Looks pretty good. And I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you're going to like it, share it, blah, blah, blah. That's probably all you hear when I'm talking right now. But again, thank you. Just have an awesome day, and I will see you around with some new videos coming up soon. thumbs up.